Back here on the regular Talk Sports Radio Extra 90.5. We'll chat some basketball coming up. The Raptors get going in the playoffs on Saturday. A lot of focus on the Leafs right now, though. Also, a lot of focus on our pre-ticket sale for Wanna Be a Spice Girls tribute coming up May 9th at the venue.
Who's your favorite Spice Girl, Graham?
Ginger.
Yeah?
I keep wanting to say Emma, but you know what? Jerry Halliwell just did it for me.
So,
especially a little bit later on in life.
I'm not on a first name basis with all of them.
Yeah.
Baby Spice, is that?
That was Emma. That was the,
yeah,
the blonde one.
Yeah, I'm definitely
the redheaded one. So tomorrow, Quarter TV and Stereo. Also at Healthy Planet, you can go pick up your tickets to go see Wannabe, a Spice Girls tribute.
Stop right now.
See, that's what I want.
Thank you very much.
That's what I want. So here's what we're going to do. Brian Goldfinger's here from Goldfinger Personal Injury Law. He's going to sing a Spice Girl.
No, apparently a big Spice Girls fan.
Apparently. Win it before you can buy it. $20 tomorrow, or you can win a pair right now. 705-874-9050. 705-874-9050. The caveat is, though, you have to serenade our good friend Brian Goldfinger from Goldfinger Personal Injury Law with a Spice Girls song. So, 705-874-9050.
Stop. Right. You know what? And it's
and
funny.
You win a pair of tickets to go see Wannabe Spice Girls tribute.
And correct me if I'm wrong, because I usually am, and you like correcting me.
Always.
A lot of guys don't like to admit they like the Spice Girls. And I love them. I love them when they were.
Except you tickets.
Their movie was crap.
This is also true.
But they could sing.
But Meatloaf was in the movie.
Yes, Meatloaf was in the
he
movie.
Drove the bus.
Drove the double decker.
The biggest Spice Girls fan I know is Brian Goldfinger.
He's huge.
Goldfinger. He's the man with the Midas touch.
Do you expect me to talk? No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to buy.
If I call him a Spice Girls fan again, maybe dying might be the appropriate term there.
Yeah.
Mr. Goldfinger, how are you?
Well, if you want to be my lover, you got to get with my friends. That's what I tell people.
He is a Spice Girl fan. See, I knew it.
705-874-9050, a pair of tickets to go see Wannabe Spice Girls tribute. Just give us a call, 705-874-9050, but you got to serenade a Spice Girls song to our good friend Brian Goldfinger.
Yeah. There's some good choices there.
Because he needs some help, because apparently he is just way too busy to watch Raptors playoff basketball.
I'm not way too busy. I got other things on the go.
He's got parental
commitments. They give the Raptors, you know, the funny times, like Saturday at 5 o'clock. You know, I'm with my kids. I'm doing a swimming lesson.
That comes first, Graham. Yeah. You know that.
No, it doesn't. my kids are dead to me. Everyone's dead to me. It's playoff time. It's playoff time right now. We got a phone call.
Already? Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
So let's find out. This is Regulars. Good morning.
Good morning. I would like those Spice Girls tickets.
You do. But you know what the consolation is, though, right? You have to sing to Brian Goldfinger a Spice Girls song.
Well, I just, if you want to be my lover.
There you go.
Awesome.
Last forever.
Awesome.
Friendship never ends.
Doesn't want to stop. He wants to keep going.
He should be in the show.
Do you got one more?
No, I not off the top of my head.
Okay.
Stop right now.
Who are we talking to?
Dakota Leahy.
Dakota, you got a pair of tickets, okay, buddy?
Okay, perfect. Sounds good.
What are you doing, like cutting the lawn out there? Or are you doing some racing?
No,
what's going on?
Leaf blowing the back on the concrete.
Leaf blowing while singing the Spice Girls.
Yeah, that doesn't happen until after about 10 o'clock tonight after the Leafs get... No, never mind. We'll talk about that later.
That is so Peterborough, isn't it?
Congratulations, Dakota. You can come by and pick up a pair of tickets from our office at Peterborough Square, okay?
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
There you go. Good friend Dakota Leahy. He has, like, by the way, when it comes to Movember, if it's the right guy, the guy I think of, he's got the biggest stash of ever. He had one that was going all the way down to his nipples, I think, at one point.
That's
so
very attractive.
It certainly
it's
is.
It's a good look on him.
So back to Brian Goldfinger's personal life. The fact he's just too busy for playoff basketball and hockey these days. So
Not hockey.
Okay, so it starts late enough. That's
hockey's
okay.
Late enough, yeah, and the games go late because they go to overtime and there's a lot of whistles. So hockey, I'm okay. But just basketball, when the NBA puts the Raptors on at weird times, like Saturday at 4 or 5 o'clock, it makes it a bit difficult for
and
me.
And three words, right? It is a new age. PVR.
Exactly.
And Brian's all over it, for yeah. sure.
So Raptors 5 o'clock on Saturday against, you know, a very formidable opponent in the 7th spot with Matt Orlando. But, you know what? This could be an interesting series, too, yes?
It's going to be interesting. Orlando's going to give it their all. But here's a bold hot take. The Raptors have been swept by the Washington Wizards in the playoffs.
Yeah.
They've also experienced a sweeping at the hand of LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers. I'm going on the record, and I'm saying that for the first time in Raptors history, they will sweep. They will sweep the Orlando Magic.
Wow.
There you go. Hot take.
Take that in. They split the season series.
Series means absolutely nothing.
I agree.
I'm looking at this. The best player on the floor is going to be Kawhi Leonard. The second best player on the floor is going to be Pascal Siakam. The third best player on the floor is going to be Kyle Lowry. You have three all-stars. I know Siakam didn't make the all-star team, but he was certainly playing at an all-star caliber. When you have the three best players in the series, you should not lose a game. There you go,
Orlando.
I think that's what the NBA knows. That's why they're putting him at 5 o'clock, because the Raptors are just going to smoke him. That's what I think. Orlando has very minimal playoff experience. Their starting point guard is DJ Augustine. He's had a great season, DJ, but frankly, he's a journeyman player. Their lone all-star is Nick Vucevic, and Vucevic is a big man. They need somebody to deliver the ball to him. He won't have the ball often. The guys who will have ball in hand will be Kyle Lowry, Kawhi Leonard, Pascal Siakam, even Danny Green to that extent, and Orlando's ball handlers and Evan Fournier and DJ Augustine. They just won't be able to compete.
Man, putting it all out there, Brian Goldfinger.
There you go.
Wow.
He had a lot of time to think about this on his way in.
I did.
Brian Goldfinger from Goldfinger Personal Injury Law is... I mean, we in the NHL, we were talking about some of the quote-unquote sexy matchups, and of course, a lot of them think it's Boston and Toronto because that's why it gets the 8 o'clock primetime spot on Saturday. Works out well, too, because now the Raptors play at 5. Those at Jurassic Park can turn over to Maple Leaf Square and then watch the Leafs right after, so you can spend the entire day and night at Maple Leaf Square.
To see a more competitive series between Boston and Toronto. Now, a lot of people are down on Toronto, and correct me if I'm wrong, I'm not the biggest hockey fan, but last year against Boston... The Leafs went to 7, right?
Yeah, they were down 3-1, and they went back and took it to 7.
And yes. They also had another 7-game series with the Bruins, correct?
Yes, we don't talk about that series.
That was the Gardner series?
No, the Gardner series was last year.
That was the four-goal collapse in the third period.
Okay, that was the Reimer series when Phaneuf's wife looked at Reimer's wife in the box, and there was that meme. Okay.
Yes.
So here for all the Leafs fans...
I hear they might be looking for a lawyer for that still, by the way.
Is there another prediction coming?
There is. All right. So for all the Leafs fans who are in very much worry about the Boston Bruins, the big difference between those Leaf teams and this Leaf team is we're adding John Tavares to the mix.
Thank you. I've been saying this all year. Graham's been fighting with me. Thank you.
We're adding John Tavares to the mix, and John Tavares is going to be the best player in the series. And if John Tavares is the best player in the series and Freddie Anderson plays like Freddie Anderson should play, the Leafs should win. I'm not predicting a bold sweep by the Leafs, but the Leafs should win the series. There you go.
And you know, you make a good point. Tavares is coming off his best season ever. Point-wise, he's in the city that he wanted to come to. I think he's a man on a mission, and a man on a mission with talent is pretty deadly.
I saw Zdeno Chara last week in the old folks' home I was visiting, and he looked pretty rickety. There you go.
But that's the thing is, I think whenever and we talk about the second season, and everyone starts at zero, and there's a dividing wall there. But one of the interesting things, too, is that we put a lot of pressure on those stats that we see from the regular season and how good Boston was, especially against the Leafs, how good Boston was going on that long winning streak for the longest time.
That's right. And another factor, Graham, as you know, is the Leafs hadn't been burning it up the last month and a half of the season. They had some issues.
No, they were burnt out. Anderson faced a lot of rubber throughout the course of the season. And I don't understand why the NHL doesn't load manage like the NBA. So I saw, I think, for the last regular season game for the Leafs, I can't recall who it was against, but I just remember seeing, was that the Habs game?
Yeah.
And it had zero implication for Toronto, correct?
Yeah, correct.
And I saw Matthews out there for long stretches, and Tavares out there for long stretches, and Marner out there for long stretches. I don't know why they're playing and risking injury.
Well, Tampa did the same thing. They were going for
the record.
And they played all their starters. Now look how it worked out for them last night. They ended up losing.
But at least they were going for something, you know. But Brian's right. But now, Brian, in that game, they did sit for their starting six defensemen. So
yeah, I'd sit the guys who put the biscuit in the basket.
I don't disagree.
I don't get it. Call up all the Marlies or whoever you can call up. It means absolutely nothing. It was a great game. It went to overtime, and that rookie from Montreal in his first game had a hat trick and scored in the shootout. Yep. It was a great, entertaining game, but it meant absolutely nothing for the Leafs, and I was cringing watching the game, hoping nobody got injured for the blue and white.
I definitely wouldn't have started Freddie Anderson in that game.
Yeah.
Game one, of course, tonight at 6:30, pregame show, 7 o'clock puck drop here on Extra 90.5, the Leafs and Bruins. Again, game two, Saturday. What a full package on Saturday. You've got the Masters going on. You got the Raptors at 5 at Scotiabank Arena. And then you've got game two between the Leafs and Bruins. As we mentioned, I'm going out to Costco. Going to get the giant container of cheese balls.
Oh, I love it!
And you know what? See if I can get myself a case of Mountain Dew, and I'm good to go.
And you know what? When those events aren't on, and there's a little break in between, I'm sure there's poker on Sportsnet. Or something. it seems to be on all the time.
Going back to the NBA, though, we talked a lot about the Raptors. Of course, you're calling for a sweep.
A sweep, yes.
Is there any other sexy matchups? I mean, Boston-Indiana looks like it could be a good series.
I want to just go back to the Raptors draw, because the Raptors, if they sweep and if they advance in the second round, they would get the winner of Philadelphia-Brooklyn. I think that'll be a great matchup. But I also like that the Raptors are in the opposite draw of Milwaukee. They're in the opposite draw of Boston as well. So they would only see Milwaukee or Boston in a conference final, which is great. And hopefully by that time, they're kind of beat up.
Yeah.
A sexy kind of first round matchup that I like. I'm curious to see what Boston does against Indiana. I think that'll be tough. Indiana, I see being as a tough out. The 1-8, Detroit and Milwaukee, I think that'll be a bit tougher on Milwaukee than you think, just because Blake Griffin is such a handful. But Milwaukee should survive that handily. And I'm also curious to see the Brooklyn-Philly matchup, just because they're so close, Brooklyn and Philadelphia, in terms of geography. Mm-hmm. And there's just a lot of bad blood there. So that should be a fun series, too.
Looking forward to it. A lot of basketball coming up, and a lot of hockey as well, with the Stanley Cup and the NBA playoffs going on at the same time. Are we okay with these two going on at the same time? Does it add a little more flavor, a little more excitement in our sporting lives at this
point? There's too much going on. There's too much going on.
Including swimming, apparently.
Yeah.
Swimming, yeah, exactly. Swimming, too. there's too much going on.
Yeah, the Blue Jays going on. I mean, they're not lighting things up, but they had a good game against Boston the other night, I thought.
They did.
Yeah, that's great. If I wanted to watch minor league baseball, I'd tune into the Toledo Mudheads.
Oh, there you go.
So there's my take on the Jays, and I keep that take for the whole season, and I'm not wavering in that take.
You know what, though? But seriously, the Jays are playing about as well as anyone expected them to, so they are living up to expectations.
Boston, though, on a bit of a slide. They're starting pitching.
3-9 right now.
Yeah.
The starting pitching is just a little slow to get going.
I have Porcello in my pool. I don't want to talk about it.
And then they'll go on like a 20-game win streak, you'll see. Like, Boston will be fine. They'll be right there.
It's April.
It's interesting, though, with Boston on a slow start, Yankees with their injury problems already. It's just a bit of a funny start, especially in the AL East.
And word just came down they're going to lose their number one guy, pitching guy, Luis Severino, into June now, potentially.
Well, if the Jays held on to Pilar and the other guys they traded, it was the big DH, Kendry Morales, you know, and if they could have fielded a major league lineup, you never know. They could have been in first place in the AL East right now.
It is a compelling story, though, that Vladdy Guerrero will come up to this team, and that... You know, that's not going to turn the team around, but I'm anxious to see him bat against some major league pitching.
Supposed to be moving up to Buffalo in the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, sooner than that. I think. Yeah. With the Bison. So
certainly it is a very busy time in sports. And then all of a sudden you got that lull until the CFL starts.
Yeah.
CFL's great.
Yeah, yeah. But you got you get so emotional right now with all the playoff series going on because you're so into it. Like, how many games did you watch? Any hockey games last night?
I was working at night, but I was able to catch like the third period in the overtime of I saw the Islanders game. Yep. Penguins. What a game! What a crowd in Long Island. Just fantastic.
And I gave that one like no time before. I was like, yeah, that's not even one on my radar.
That crowd was unbelievable in that game. And then I caught the tail end of the Tampa Columbus comeback. The comeback by Columbus, just phenomenal. There's nothing better than the first round of the NHL playoffs. Fantastic.
In my world, perfect world, the Leafs meet the Islanders in the playoffs at some point.
Wouldn't that be nice?
That would be awesome. Yeah. Johnny Tavares can have some fun on that.
Back home. Too. There you go.
Yep.
This is the regular Stock Sports Radio Extra 90.5. Our good friend Brian Goldfinger from Goldfinger Personal Injury Law here as well. So again, Raptors game one goes 5 o'clock on Saturday. Normally, what's your game day, playoff game day ritual? What are you up to?
Oh, just surviving with the kids. Surviving at work and then surviving with the kids, and then hopefully the game's on and have the game on PVR generally. Do a bit of work and then don't look at social media because that'll ruin the game for me, and then watch the game. And if anyone ruins the game for me, I'll sue them.
And you know what? I don't know about you, Brian. It happens to me all the time. You know, you get through everything. It's all, you know, you're good. You've got all your social media off. You're on your way home. You decide to stop for a coffee at Tim Hortons. The girl who serves you, who has never watched a Leaf game in her life, says, "How about those Leafs tonight?" No. Wow.
What, all the cars driving with their honking their me, 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 me.
It never fails, right?
Yeah, okay.
So anyway, good luck with that.
Are there any other series that you are intent to watch in the NBA?
In the NBA, Portland versus, I think it's OKC. I think that'll be an interesting one on the West Coast. And then the Clippers, Golden State, Golden State should take them handily. And then, who's Utah playing? I think that'll be interesting. I think Utah have the Rockets?
Utah has Houston, yeah.
That'll be a very interesting series, Utah-Houston, because you have two very conflicting styles. And then you have a very good rim protector for Utah in Gobert.
Yeah.
So Harden might be neutralized on his drive. So that should be a very interesting series, the 4-5.
So is it also going to be interesting to see how DeMar kind of goes?
Who's San Antonio playing?
Double check that. They got Denver.
Oh, that'll be a neat series, too.
Yeah. It'll be interesting. I want to see how DeMar kind of goes with the flow going in the postseason with a new team this year.
He'll be good. He'll be fine.
Yeah?
He's got Popovich. He's got Aldridge. They'll be a tough out at San Antonio.
Just because you saw how much he was the catalyst for the Raptors in their playoff series. He was, you know, points he seemed like he was a one-man team out there.
Right.
He's a guy.
Obviously, he's got a little more of a supporting cast, I would say, in San Antonio.
But in that series against Denver, I mean, Denver's star player is a center, Jokic. Yeah. Right, so the best player on the court with the ball in their hands arguably could be DeMar DeRozan. So that might be interesting because they're not playing, say, Houston, who's a clear-cut superstar, or they're not playing, you know, Golden State, who has a clear-cut superstar in Durant or Curry.
Brian, we've talked about this before, but I think it bears repeating. How important is a good, strong playoff run, hopefully pretty deep, by the Raptors in terms of Kawhi Leonard staying in Toronto next year?
It'll mean everything. If they have a good, deep playoff run, I think he's sticking around. If they fizzle out and my predictions don't hang true on the Raptors, he'll be out of town playing for the Clippers real soon.
So there's more at stake here.
There's a lot at stake, for the Raptors' future.
Brian Goldfinger from Goldfinger Personal Injury Law here on the Regulus for a few more moments. Of course, you have a great blog that you write up when you're not watching Raptors basketball. This time around, you're talking about long-term disability claims.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know what a long-term disability claim is. You may have insurance through an employer, through an insurance company like Great West Life, Manulife, Standard Life, Sun Life, etc. And something bad might happen in your life. You might experience some illness or an unfortunate accident and you can't return to work. Long-term disability benefits are supposed to supplement your income. Most policies go up to the age of 65, and a lot of people don't know that they have those benefits. And when they look for benefits, they look through perhaps Ontario Works or ODSP or CPP Disability, not full well knowing that they may have coverage through their employer. And oftentimes we represent people who have been denied benefits or had their benefits terminated in terms of getting those benefits reinstated or getting them a lump sum.
So what happens in that situation then?
In that situation, first, the claimant needs to apply. It's not like a car accident where an obvious event took place and there's a bad accident and we can just go out there and sue, the claimant needs to take an affirmative step. They need to apply, and the application process can often be daunting and difficult. There's a big form to complete, not just by you, but also by your employer. There's also a form that needs to be completed by a doctor or a specialist. That form completed by the doctor or specialist is called the disability certificate. It has to justify your disability. So if you're sending the disability certificate to a doctor who does not believe you're disabled, then you probably will get denied disability because they're not going to fill it out in a certain way that shows you're disabled. So that's very important as well. After the application forms have been completed and submitted, the insurance company says yay or nay to the application. If they say yay and pay benefits, then you don't need a lawyer like me in your life. In the event that they say nay and don't approve your benefits, you then have the option of appealing, which frankly is like bringing a rubber knife to a gunfight. It's not going to happen. You need to lawyer up in that situation, or you do nothing. If you do nothing, I can guarantee this, and it's not often a lawyer can guarantee something. If you do nothing, you will get nothing. Money will just not fall from the sky. Insurance companies are not in the business of all of a sudden changing their minds because they're nice.
Yeah.
They will let a two-year limitation period lapse such that in the event you hire a lawyer like me after the two-year denial, you won't be able to sue because a limitation period will have lapsed. So they bank on people either A, doing nothing, or people with psychological and mental illness not having the strength to get out of the bed, not having the strength to call a lawyer like me to sue, or not having the confidence to reach out to a lawyer. They bank on that, and oftentimes they're very successful because mental illness is very real.
Wow.
There you go. Heavy stuff.
Very heavy.
Yeah, but, I'll say.
But the catalyst I got from that is, if you're not happy, call this guy over here.
with a good Spice Girl song, too.
That's an interesting process, Brian, as you laid it out. But give us an idea of the volume of you know, your work that would involve disability claims. Or is it pretty?
It's pretty significant. Yeah, there's a lot of claims out there. I'd say probably our practice is between 30 to 45% long-term disability related, and very often these are cases that unions just can't handle. So very often you have unionized employees who think, well, my union's got my back, they'll do it for me, and they just don't have the know-how or the resources to do it, and it's just not within their skill set. So they get their blessing to seek out a lawyer like me to help out unionized employees with these fights.
The one thing that you had said, which struck true to me, because having a son with special needs, I'm always applying for funding for this, that, or the other, and it's always about those forms, and very daunting forms, and they're meant, they almost seem like they're meant to be daunting, so you look at it and go,
so people give up.
I can't do this.
I wish everything could be a nice interview like we're having right now, like you go in and you meet somebody nice and they help you fill it out, but unfortunately that's not the way life works. Life requires you to sit down and focus on a set of forms, and very often you can't just sit down and focus because your cell phone is ringing, your kids are yelling, or you got somewhere else to be, you got to work, you got a job, but it's filling out those forms and then getting them in. What often happens is the Canada Post monster eats it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you want to drop them off, and then finding the time to drop them off personally is a different story. And then not photocopying the forms, because if the Canada Post monster eats the forms, you need to redo them again, or you need to have a set, another copy handy. And oftentimes you don't do that because you haven't made copies. So what I tell people is scan them in. If you have a scanner at home, they're about $100, certainly a worthwhile investment. Scan them in. You can email them to the insurance company. Sometimes they'll accept it by way of email, and also follow up by sending it by regular mail or send it by fax. The nice thing about fax and email is that you have confirmation sheets.
Yeah.
Okay. The thing about regular mail sometimes is you say, I mailed it, but you don't have proof of that.
Yeah.
So then you send it registered mail. Registered mail is certainly a bit more expensive, but at least you have proof of it.
Yeah.
So there you go.
Brian Goldfinger from Goldfinger Personal Injury Law. How can people find you, my friend?
Visit the website, goldfingerlaw.com, or certainly email me, Brian, B-R-I-A-N, at goldfingerlaw.com.
I always learn something when Brian comes in, you know? today I learned, among other things, that the Raptors...
Will sweep
the first round of the playoffs.
Instead of being swept, they will sweep.
Awesome. In case you want to talk about long-term disability claims, give him a call around 6 or 7 o'clock on Saturday night while he's watching the Raptors game.
He'll be happy
to take your call, man. Brian, always is a pleasure. It's always a good time to have you come in. And again, looking forward to seeing how the Raptors play things out.
Thanks. Go Leafs, go.
There we go. Go Leafs, thanks, go indeed. Brian. 7 o'clock tonight here on Extra 90.5.
You are a clever, resourceful man, Mr. Bond.
Well, thank you.
Perhaps too clever.
Regulus continues after break here on Extra.